Welcome to Film Flickers. I'm your host, Jessica Headley. It's alternate reality time. You know that place you like to go when you just want to imagine you have superpowers? Well, this time you don't have to close your eyes. We're bringing you Spider-Man's webby world, Hercules' strength and a dragon spell, and an X-Men curse that superpowers get to alter. And I have my colors on, Spider-Man style. During tonight's show, you can win all sorts of great prizes, but to win, like us on Facebook right now and play along. You'll also find valuable clues on our Film Flickers Facebook page. Good guys, superheroes rarely come in the form of arrogance. And in keeping with that, Spider-Man is more than ever showing you a deeper, more relatable human side in his return to the big screen.
The beauty of Spider-Man, he's owning the symbol and he's making it more that open, warm protector that kids feel reassured and excited by.
Yo, Sparkle!
Sometimes in movies when people are wearing suits and you can't see their face, there's a feeling you get that it's somebody in a suit.
Heads up, watch out!
What Andrew does brilliantly is eliminated that barrier.
You all right?
You're Spider-Man.
Okay. Yeah, costume gives it away, huh? But something pretty important, Max.
How do you know my name?
It's written on your badge.
See out there.
Andrew, he can do it all. He can have the humor, he can have the conflict, he can do stunts that most people don't. Very few people will be willing to sit at this corner looking over the world and saying, I want to feel this. Because if I feel it, I can make you believe that I'm sitting in a place that no one else can.
Peter Parker.
As actors, that's what it's all about. It's grabbing the character.
Nice outfit.
And you really get a sense of it when you see Andrew Garfield in the Spider-Man suit.
I'm such a huge Spider-Man fan, and I know how important it is. I know what it can do for kids. I know what it can do for not kids. I know what it can do for anyone that watches.
This is the plan. You get the elevator, I'm gonna distract him, okay?
I'm really excited. I love how joyful it is and playful it is. Spider-Man being trickster, just kind of acting like a kid.
Oh, I just spilled a hot latte all over your... I didn't mean to do that.
Oh, I'm here.
Sir?
Mr. Stay right there.
Wait. All right, on your way. I'm sorry, I'm all thumbs today.
I really feel there's something for everyone in it.
Spider-Man climbs into Santikos Theaters this Friday. If this new Spider-Man doesn't activate your spidey senses, nothing will. Time to play Who Said That? If you know this week's famous movie quote, you'll win Brenner and a movie for two from IHOP and Santikos Theaters. All right, here it is. Secrets have a cost. They're not free, not now, not ever. Email us at whosaidthat@filmflickers.com. We'll take the 10th and 20th correct answers. Be sure to put your answer in the subject line. And don't forget to check out our Facebook page for a hint. Last week's winners are Ashley Graham and Mike Scott, who correctly answered Leonardo DiCaprio as Cobb in Inception. Congratulations to you. The awe and aura of Spider-Man establishes him as a cultural icon in our society. And tonight's Spotlight interview, Jamie Foxx, Emma Stone, Andrew Garfield weigh in on the character development side of their web.
It's just closer to the Spider-Man I think we all know and love. And definitely for me, like the eyes are larger. It's just more friendly. It's a warmer suit. And it's a warm character. So, you know, that's where Peter is as Spider-Man, and that's where the movie is right now. That's where we are in the story of Spider-Man, is that he's owning the symbol more, and he's making it more that thing that kids love, that open, warm, bright kind of protector that kids feel reassured and excited by, and that I feel reassured and excited by.
The tone is very alive. It's crackling with life, and there's a lot of, it's a roller coaster, this second one. So there's a different vibe entirely, I think, on set and in the creation of it. And in the script, it's just very, it's very big and poppy and alive.
Playing the role of Electro and people hearing about me and Spider-Man, that was just like vibration that went through all of everywhere. Like friends at home, people in Hollywood. And you really get a sense of it when you walk on the set and you see Andrew Garfield in the Spider-Man suit. It took us a moment. We took a moment and I said, wow, this is really something in history. No one would be able to take these moments away from us. We're doing something that people really love. This is part of our fabric, it's part of our culture.
Reporting live from New York One, Chopper, an Oscorp truck carrying plutonium has been hijacked. A police chase is in progress.
Gotcha. Nope, got you too. Hey, you're not going anywhere. Come here. Come to Daddy. Okay, stop it. Oh, come on.
More to come on Spider-Man, but for now, it's picture perfect time. And this week's picture, tell me what Spider-Man villain this is, and you'll win dinner and a movie for two at KFC and Santikos Theaters. You can find a clue on our Facebook page if you need help. Be the 10th and 20th person to email me at pictureperfect@filmflickers.com. And don't forget to put your answer on the subject line. Last week's picture perfect winner was Leah Sines, who knew this scene was from Mean Girls. Good job. If you'd like your company featured on Film Flickers in one of our movie contests, email us at prizes@filmflickers.com. In this week's Film Flickers Special Access Pass, let's see how Spider-Man stops one moment in time to save everyone in Times Square.
Stay with me, Max.
You set me up.
No, I didn't set you up.
You lied to me.
No, try to help. Let me help you.
Cool. It's like Spider-Man's web now has the power of the freeze frame. Actors love being in sequels, or do they? That, plus more coming up in your Hollywood Buzz after the break. Welcome back. It's time for all your latest film news in What's Up, Hollywood? Lindsay Lohan dropped a bomb in her finale episode of her own TV show. Supposedly, she had a miscarriage during its filming duration. Her show will not be renewed, so this begs the question, is this another PR stunt or a pressing issue for Lohan? It's confirmed Paul Walker's brothers Caleb and Cody will be standing in for him to finish off the scenes never completed by Walker's untimely death last November. Robin Williams is like a kid on candy, hoping a sequel to Mrs. Doubtfire will finally get made. But not everyone's on board. Remember cute child star Mara Wilson, who also starred in beloved movies like Miracle on 34th Street? She says sequels have never really been her thing. The 1980s box office hit Top Gun is getting a remake. It's said to team up Tom Cruise and Jerry Bruckheimer. Since the 80s, a lot of military warfare has changed, so expect to see drones and the like this time around. Rumor has it Penelope Cruz could be the next Bond girl in next year's 2015 rendition of 007. And Chelsea Clinton's in the news twice in one week. She premiered as executive producer of her short film, Of Many. She and her husband also announced they're pregnant. Sounds like two firsts for you, Chelsea. For What's Up, Hollywood, that's a wrap. Everything that happens now is in your hands. X-Men Days of Future Past leaves larger-than-life hints on how this concept abounds in the fictitious world and in present day. I have a feeling we may take home a few life lessons after viewing this one.
Professor?
You're gonna find this hard to believe.
I was sent here for you.
From the future?
50 years from now.
Could you give me that one more time, please?
Stay with me.
In the beginning, the Sentinels were just targeting mutants. Then they began targeting everyone. They've come a long way to guide us, to bring us together. The X-Men, we need your help.
Tell whoever it was that sent you. I'm busy.
The person who sent me was you.
It's going to take all of us to end this war.
You're Beast?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Pretty strong for a scrawny kid. I said you need to leave.
You and I are going to be good friends. You just don't know it yet.
We're going to need Mystique.
Why?
You're a cold-hearted bitch.
Well, don't hold back.
Where's Magneto?
That man is a monster. He's being held 100 floors beneath the most heavily guarded building on the planet.
I know a guy. He'd be a young man now.
He's fascinating.
He's a pain in the ass.
Prison break? That's illegal, you know.
Only if you get caught.
Charles. Good to see you too, old friend.
This is gonna be fun.
There is a new enemy out there. You'll need a new weapon for this war.
Everything that happens now is in your hands.
And your power to change the future in several weeks in Santikos theaters. Here's this week's movie scramble. Unscramble these letters to reveal the winning answer. If you're correct, you'll win dinner at Rudy's Barbecue and Santikos movie tickets for two people. Email your answer to moviescramble@filmflickers.com. The fifth and 15th correct email will win. Please put your answer in the subject line. And a big congrats to last week's movie scramble winner, Anna Rodriguez. The answer was Meryl Streep. Spider-Man, aka Peter Parker, is the good guy. But what about the bad guys? Here's an inside look with actor Dane DeHaan, who plays Peter's best friend and the enemy, the Green Goblin.
It was just so exciting because it's such a full, dynamic, crazy, like, arc of a character, something I knew I could really sink my teeth into, and that wouldn't just be like another like stereotypical part in a big franchise movie, but is actually something with a lot of dimension and depth, and something that I could really like create a character from.
You're gonna want to see this.
Oscorp.
He had you under surveillance.
Why?
Isn't that the question of the day?
Andrew's someone that I've wanted to work with ever since I saw him, and I was like, wow, this kid can really act. He's one of the most like emotionally available actors, I think, in our age group.
Peter Parker.
Harry Osborn.
It's been 10 years. What have you been up to?
I do some web design.
Makes you want to think twice about who you choose as your best friend. What do a dragon and Hercules have in common? They're both in summer blockbusters coming up right after the break. Welcome back. So just how do you train your dragon? Well, that business was taken care of in the first How to Train Your Dragon. Expect in the second installment an exploration of lands unknown and the discovery of an ice cave filled with hundreds of new wild dragons. Here's to keeping the peace in a whole new world.
Come on, bud. There's a whole other world of dragons out there.
Unbelievable.
What do you say? What should we name it? Itchy Armpit it is.
I bet you think you know a lot about dragons.
Should I know you?
No, but a mother never forgets.
Every dragon has its secrets. I'll show them all to you.
Did you know about this?
That's your mother?
Now you know where I get my dramatic flair.
He likes you.
Wow.
Something is coming. Something you've never faced before.
What's down there?
I alone control the dragons. Drago Bloodfist is a madman.
I'll buddy his fist with my face if he tries to take my dragon.
Dad, there's something you need to know.
Oh boy.
I know what you're gonna say.
You're as beautiful as the day I lost you.
What a team now. Now what do you want to do?
Drago's coming for our dragons. We have to stop him. Together.
Don't worry, bud. I'm not gonna let anything happen to you. You have the heart of a chief.
That's my boy!
And the soul of a dragon.
You know that doesn't wash out.
Cut them down!
Dragon Rider's coming through! We can't fly these things!
They're babies! They don't listen to anyone!
Take them down, babe!
Come on, bud! Hold on! Distract the Alpha!
Have a nice flight!
Uh-oh.
Gerard Butler, Kate Blanchett, Kristen Wiig, and Jonah Hill are just a few of the big names collaborating when this one blows some fire into Santikos theaters this summer. Dwayne Johnson, aka The Rock, tries his hand at the Greek demigod Hercules. Can he convince you? Here's the Brett Ratner-directed potential summer blockbuster.
How far you go, man cannot escape his fate. Who are you? Are you a murderer? Are you a mercenary who turns his back on the innocent? We believe in you. We have faith in you. Remember the deeds you have performed, the labors you have accomplished. Are you only the legend, or are you the truth behind the legend? Now, tell me, who are you?
It's your voice, it's your king, and it could be your prize coming up. Welcome back. It's time now for our box office king of the week. For the third week standing, Captain America gets crowned, and Rio 2 closely followed. For new releases, the highly rated Heaven is for Real got real with 21 million and Transcendence disappointed at 11 million. But let's take a look at the top new movie from this past week, Heaven is for Real.
We need to get him in surgery right away.
The pain that I suffered watching my son that close to death.
We're in trouble here. He's much worse. Will you call some friends and pray for him?
The hospital staff said that your son was not expected to survive. Use the word miracle.
Your son had a near-death experience.
He saw things that I can't really explain.
I lifted up and I looked down. Mom was in one room, you were in another room yelling at God.
He's been out there staring for hours.
Is something wrong with Colton?
Why do you say that?
Sometimes he says weird things.
I've been here.
I don't think we've been here before, pal.
You had a grandpa named Pop, right?
He died when I was about your age.
He's very nice.
You saw my grandfather? Where did you see him?
In heaven.
Is this him? Is this the man you saw?
No, in heaven, everybody's young.
Is this him?
Yeah, that's him. That's Pop.
I want to believe him, but everything he talks about is impossible.
The
You saw heaven?
What does it look like?
It's beautiful.
We all want to be supportive, but we can't have our town turn into a circus.
They don't believe me, do they?
Some people might be afraid to believe.
Don't you think we need to be talking about this life?
Do you think my son went to heaven?
You don't have to worry. He told me everything was all right.
He's making a difference.
Haven't we already had a glimpse of something? In the first cry of a baby, the courage of a friend, the love of a mother, a father, I see it, so I believe it.
Do you?
It's time for Voice of the People. Here's what your friends and family had to say about all of the happenings at Santikos Theaters.
Captain America the Winter Soldier.
It's better than the Avengers. It's really good.
It's very action-packed. I enjoyed it.
Just seems to be a really good movie. Marvel makes really good movies.
I would lie if I said Chris Evans was not a part of this decision.
Rio 2. This movie was good, and it has a lot of funny things.
Is heaven for real? It was Good Friday, and it kind of got us thinking about heaven and religion, and we were curious. We wanted to see it.
I think when you start talking about a four-year-old, you know, I don't know, they got a big imagination, but at the same time, I think they tend to tell it like it is, so it does make you stop and think.
We always love hearing from you, our viewers, so if you want to be a part of our show, head over to your local Santikos Theaters. We could film you at any one of them. Here's your last chance to win with Tinseltown Trivia. Which of these characters was the first villain to appear in the original Spider-Man comic books? Was it Kingpin, Dr. Octopus, Mysterio, or the Chameleon? Email us your answer to movie trivia at filmflickers.com, and if you are the 10th and 20th person to email us, you'll win a special Spider-Man prize pack courtesy of Santikos Theaters. Last week's winner was Sherry Bell, and the correct answer was Anne Hathaway. Don't forget, for more Movie Madness, you can also join me Thursday nights and Friday mornings on Fox San Antonio and News 4 San Antonio for Santikos Movie Moments. Time to say goodnight from all of us at Film Flickers. Just like the imagination, the movie world's possibilities are endless. Film Flickers lights up the screen again next week with more movie magic. Until then, I'm Jessica Headley with Film Flickers.